such an honor and so great to be with all of you guys here today. It is so inspiring to see all these young people get up early on a Saturday morning and come out to engage in a project like this. You guys are so fortunate. You just have no idea what you have at your fingertips with technology. I went to high school in San Francisco, and when I went to high school all those years ago, none of this existed. There was literally no technology. And we lived in a completely different world. And think about that. In just the span of 30 or 40 years, the entire world has changed. When has that ever happened in history before? That in such a short period of time, the whole world has changed. Let me give you an example. When I was in college, I went overseas to Europe to study. And I was there for 6 months. And the only communication I had with my family was once every 2 weeks, I got to a payphone and could have a 5-minute conversation with my family. And that was the only communication I had. And the only news I could ever get was that an English language newspaper would be published every other day, and I would try to get a copy and read news that was already 2 or 3 days old. Now imagine if this was you guys, and you went to Europe today to study. You'd land, you'd go to where you were staying, and 5 minutes into your stay, you'd be FaceTiming with your family back home. It would be completely different. You'd go on CNN.com and see what happened in the last hour. There'd be no delay at all. So you guys are really lucky, and you're even luckier, and you know why? Because you live in the center of the universe for technology. This is where it started. This is where it all happens. You could not be in a better place when it comes to technology. Now, I work for the California Attorney General, and I'm a trial lawyer, and everyone in this room is more skilled at technology than I am, I guarantee you. But technology still plays a role in what I do, because I have to persuade people to come to the opinion that I'm trying to get them to take. For example, I'm a trial lawyer. I go in front of a jury and I try to convince them that our case has the correct position, that we're right on our side. And how do we do that? Well, nowadays, different from when I started out, technology plays a big role because we can use technology in the courtroom to help persuade the jurors. What do I mean by that? Well, we can develop presentations using technology that through, whether it's through video or through text that we put up on the screen, we're able to persuade folks in a way that we couldn't persuade them in the past. Now, it's still important to have communication skills. I don't think anything's more important than that. So you guys always want to work on your communication skills. But if you use your communication skills along with technology, you can be really effective. And you guys can change the world. And I know people say that to you all the time, and you're like, sure, I'm gonna change the world. But really, you guys can change the world because through technology, you can make things happen and have an impact. Let me give you a couple examples, okay? The past year, I was fortunate that I got to work in my spare time when I wasn't working for the Attorney General on a mayoral campaign. And I worked for a woman whose name you might know. Her name is London Breed. She's the mayor of San Francisco now. And during that time, I got to participate in a campaign that was using technology to try to persuade the voters of San Francisco to vote for London Breed. And she was in a really tough race with, among others, Jane Kim, the young man you just heard speak on her behalf. She was in that race and she was a tough candidate. And London Breed won that race by a couple thousand votes. Now, what made the difference? Well, one was in the old-fashioned way, going out on the streets and just working hard and meeting and talking to as many people as possible. That still is a great way to make change. But the newer way, the more modern way that made a difference was technology. Using social media, using all the means that are available to us through technology to try to persuade voters that London Breed was the right choice. So you can see that there's a little bit of an old-fashioned way to go about things. Hard work still makes a difference. Talking to people still makes a difference. But the best way to communicate to the most people is through technology. Let me give you guys another example, one that you've probably heard a little bit about in the news. Raise your hand if you heard anything about the new nominee and confirmed member of the US Supreme Court. Did anybody hear about that over the last few weeks? That was a pretty big story. And whether you're on one side or the other, and I'm not asking anybody to choose sides here, know that your use of technology will help determine how these political battles, like the one you just saw, will play out in the future. Because the reality is that a body of 9 people, like the US Supreme Court, has an effect on everything that happens in this country. And so the people that are on the Supreme Court, and whatever their personal viewpoints may be, although they're there to interpret the law and not to allow their own personal biases to make their decisions for them, the reality is that people are who they are. We all have our own opinions, and that is going to come into play. And some people are what are called strict constructionists. They interpret the Constitution in a very strict way. And others see a different way of going about determining how the law should decide something. And so you guys ask yourself, well, what can we do with technology to have an effect on something like that? Well, whoever is going to sit on the Supreme Court and decide the laws of the land is going to be decided by technology and what people like you guys do. And you say, well, how can that be? Well, here's what happens. In 2020, there's going to be a presidential election. And there's going to be people who are supporting President Trump when he runs again. And there are going to be people who are supporting whoever the Democratic candidate is for president. And whoever wins that presidential election in 2020 is most likely going to get to name at least one or two people to the US Supreme Court, because some of the members of the court are getting pretty old and are going to retire. And so that person who is elected president is going to decide who sits on the court, and the court is going to decide the laws of the land. And that's a big deal, because that will affect your day-to-day life. So people using technology are going to try to persuade the voters, as we did in a local election here, to vote for their candidate. So opportunities are going to open up for you guys as you get older, as you go to college, to play a role in all of this. And people are looking for people with skills in technology. My son, he's a computer science major in college. He tells me all the time about how there are so many opportunities out there in terms of work for people who have technology skills. It's the most sought after skill and industry that's out there. You guys chose correctly to have an interest in technology. I'm so jealous of all of you and having all the expertise that you already have. So my message to you is, understand what an incredible tool you have in technology. Understand that you, just you individually, you have a chance to change the world. Keep doing what you're doing. Go after it. You can get whatever you want. Just work hard and believe in yourself, and you guys are going to have a huge impact. I'm really honored to be with you today. Good luck at the hackathon.